Hi Virgo, welcome back to my channel, Karma Fox. I am doing your weekly love reading for May 9th through the 15th, 2021. I hope you guys are doing well. I am going to take just a second to remind you that this is a general reading and therefore it may not resonate with everyone. Keep in mind also that the roles can reverse or flip-flop and the timelines can vary in a general reading. So just take what resonates for you. Leave the rest for someone else, okay? Virgo, I'm going to pull your energy and the energy of the person you are connecting with, as well as the energy of the connection and the outcome. At the end of the reading, I will also pull the Angel Answers Oracle. So if you will get a direct question in your mind, I will see if I can get you a direct answer. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. Spirit, can I have the energy of Virgo? Virgo. Okay. All right, so Virgo, you start out with the Ace of Cups. How nice is that? All right, we have the World in reverse. And we have the Five of Wands. All right, so I do see that there is some conflict going on here. It could be internal conflict, but it feels more like it's external. We'll see as we clarify. But I also feel like with this conflict, whatever this is, I don't feel like you're willing to let this end. You may be in conflict with somebody, but it's a cycle that you're just not willing to let it go. You're not willing to let this cycle end, or you're not willing to let this connection end, even though it's in conflict, because there's a lot of love there. Now, if this is internal, this Ace of Cups could indicate self-love. Sometimes I do see that, but if not, it indicates either new love or it indicates a new beginning in love, if it's a current person. So let's see who you are connected with here. Who is Virgo connecting with? Show me who Virgo's connecting with. Okay. All right, so the person you're connecting with, we have the Ten of Swords in the reverse. We have the Two of Wands in the reverse. And we also have the Six of Cups in the reverse. So right off the bat, Virgo, I do have to tell you that the person that you are connecting with is learning some sort of a karmic lesson. So whenever I see all of the cards of one person's energy in reverse, that tells me there's a karmic lesson that's being learned here. They are somewhat at a crossroads. And I can tell you that they are not really willing to make a decision here. For some reason, they're kind of stuck. They're not really willing to choose a new direction. They have felt somewhat betrayed in the past, but they are kind of getting over that. They're kind of moving past it. Again, there's a cycle that is not, they're not allowing this cycle to end either. So the two of you kind of share that energy of not letting something go, not releasing something completely. But I do see that they are attempting to let go of their, you know, their past. Or they're letting go of some memories from the past or letting go of the past. But whatever it is, it's not completely over. Not completely. Almost, but not completely. And there is a sense of not being able to quite move forward with them as well. Let's see what the energy of the connection is. Okay, so we have the Three of Cups. Okay, so this could be somebody that you have recently met, Virgo, as you have been going out. Or there could be, I don't see any other energy of a third party here, but we will clarify it. But there seems to be, if it's not third party, there seems to be happiness in this, and it could be that this is someone that you have met as you're going out. We're going to clarify that for sure. What is directly affecting this connection? Okay, so the Ten of Pentacles. So a long-term connection. Okay, A long-term committed connection is affecting your connection, Virgo. Definitely you're going to have to clarify this. What is the outcome at the end of the week? The King of Swords. So you may be dealing with a air sign. If so, that is going to be a Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. Doesn't have to be. Could be somebody that has that in their chart or just is demonstrating those characteristics. But the outcome, this is shared energy. So the outcome at the end of the week, Virgo, is going to be that the connection is going to be a little cold, a little distant here. More on the less feeling and more analytical side of things. So I'm not getting the warm fuzzies from the feel from this. So let's see what's going on here, because I have to be honest with you, the energy here, as much as I hate to say it, is leaning towards, you know, there being some disruptions in this. And we have the sun in reverse. That's the underlying energy. Again, makes me a little nervous, because this tells me that the underlying energy here, Virgo, is that there are things that are unseen, things that are not really out in the open. So let's start clarifying. Why is the Ace of Cups here for Virgo? Why is the Ace of Cups here? Okay, so there you are, Virgo. We have the Hermit and we have the Devil. So I do feel like this is a very strong connection, Virgo, that you may feel as if you don't really understand why you have this strong connection. And it could be a little bit toxic. There's something that is a little toxic about it. I do think that you may have pulled away from this in the past. But I also think that, you know, there is something strong about this connection. Why is the World here in reverse for Virgo? Oh, wow. So we have the Four of Cups in the reverse. We have the Hierophant, and we have, again, the World in reverse. So it's very, very strong that you are unable to let this go. That's doubled the energy here. Because we have the World in reverse, clarifying the World in reverse. Even though you're not letting this go, you're not letting it end, and you want commitment from this, but in the past, I see that you have felt as if you have not been appreciated. You feel as if you've not been treated with the respect and the appreciation that you would like. And I can see here that you're unable to let it go because you want commitment in this situation. Why is the Five of Wands here? Okay, so we have the Moon. And we have the Lovers in reverse. Okay. Again, we have this shadow type of energy, Virgo. We have things that are not really out in the open. And that's what's causing this conflict. So part of it's internal, and you may have external conflict with this person too. Why? Well, because they're not making a decision. Now, this decision is either between two people, which I would have to lean towards because we have the Three of Cups here in the connection. So this person you're connected with, Virgo, is not making a decision. If it's not between two people, it's a major decision in love. And they're kind of keeping you in the dark. So you have internal conflict about it, but there may also be external conflict as you know, if you are in communication with them. Now, some of you are absolutely not in communication with them because you feel like it's a toxic connection. But just because it's toxic doesn't mean that internally you have let go of the connection. You may be right now focusing on, you know, yourself and self-love because it is toxic, but internally you haven't let it go. you have not let it go. And for others, you are in connection with them, and there's a lot of conflict in the connection because three is a crowd. Okay, so let's see. Although I do feel like most of you have pulled away from this person. I do feel like most of you, and some of you have actually blocked this person, because sometimes with a hermit we see blocking. But just a lot of energy here of things that are being hidden, things that are not out in the open. So let's see, why is the Ten of Swords here in reverse? Why is the Ten of Swords in reverse? Okay, so we have the Page of Cups and we have the Tower in reverse. So this person offered you something, Virgo, and they feel like you stabbed them in the back. They feel like you betrayed them, and that caused a Tower moment for them. But what they offered you was either very, very small or very immature or both. So it wasn't a lot, and they're feeling betrayed. They're feeling betrayed. It caused a Tower moment, but they are picking up the pieces now. They're starting to pick up the pieces of their life, and trying to move forward. Why is the Two of Wands in reverse? All right, so we have the Four of Wands and we have the Seven of Coins. Okay, so what they're not making a decision about, they're waiting, has to do with connection. It has to do with a committed connection. So they're waiting. There's a committed connection. So it's either leveling up the connection with you, or they're waiting about a committed connection. They're not choosing a path. They're not choosing a direction. And they're just waiting. They're sitting here waiting. They are still invested in something else, it looks like. Why is the Six of Cups here in reverse? Okay. So we have Temperance and we have Judgment. Okay. So they've tried to let go of the past. They've tried to let go of the connection with you. I don't think that that's happening. Or it might be their past here that they're letting go of. So they are trying to let go of their past. And I can see also, Virgo, that they do want to reconnect with you. They do want to bring this connection back. They're trying to balance out their energies. They want to reconnect with you. But I feel like they are still invested in another connection. And what they offered you was just very small. And so it looks as if you probably turned that down. A lot of you may have even blocked this person. And so what I'm seeing here is that caused them a Tower moment. Now they're trying to balance out their emotions. They're trying to heal themselves. But they do want to bring the connection back together. And see, that would make a lot of sense. If they're still invested in another connection, that's why this Ten of Pentacles is affecting your connection. Why is the Three of Cups here for the connection? Because I don't normally see the Three of Cups for the connection. That threw me a little bit, I'll be honest with you. All right, so we have the Eight of Swords. We have, again, the Six of Cups. And, okay, in their energy, we have the Ace of Pentacles and the Hanged Man. Okay. So yeah, there's third party energy here. You feel trapped with that. This is a soulmate for you. And I do feel like it's somebody you've known from your past. You've either known for a very long time, possibly since childhood, or it is somebody you've known from a previous life. Now, you're feeling very trapped in this energy because it's third party. That's where the conflict is coming from for you. And so what I'm seeing is, Virgo, they are kind of waiting. They're trying to wait. They're waiting you out. They're waiting to have a new beginning with you. but they're still invested here in something else. But they are trying to have a new beginning with you. Why is the Ten of Pentacles here? Oh. Okay, let me fish for that card. Knight of Wands and the Six of Swords in the reverse. So they're stuck in whatever that connection is. It may be a connection they've been in a very long time with the Ten of Pentacles. So they're stuck in it. They're not able to move forward from that connection for some reason. And you, Virgo, are seeing them as a player. The Knight of Wands is a player. So you're seeing them as a player. And that you're kind of, you feel trapped, but it's really, you're in your head about it, Virgo. Because you can step out of that energy at any time. So, but they are stuck. They're stuck in this connection. They're still invested here in another connection, but they are trying to reconnect with you. They're waiting to reconnect with you and they're being very patient about it. Let me get three for the outcome. Three for the outcome, please. All right, so in the outcome, we have the Queen of Wands in reverse, we have the Queen of Pentacles, and we have the Two of Coins. So the outcome is, at the end of the week, the connection is going to be somewhat cold. Like I said, you may be dealing with a air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, don't have to be, but it's going to be a little bit cold on both sides, actually, because that's shared energy. And sitting right in the middle of it, the reason for that is the Queen of Pentacles. Now, the Queen of Pentacles is the committed partner. That's who this person you're connected with has the investment with. So they're invested with this Queen of Pentacles. That's the committed partner here. That's why there's a coldness in this connection. Now, they wanted you to be the third party. They wanted you in the upright. The Queen of Wands is sometimes the third party. They wanted you in the upright. You said, oh, no, no, I am not going to be a third party. And so you're in the reverse here. And you've gone cold on this person because you're saying, I'm not going to be a third party. I'm not going to be, you know, your third party. I'm not going to do it. And so you're taking no action towards this connection. You see them as a player. You are feeling stuck in it because you do still have emotions for this person. But I do think that you are putting the love into yourself. You're putting it self-love for you. That being said, you do have emotions for them and you're waiting for that commitment. Even though you're probably saying, no, I'm not doing it. I mean, you can say it all you want, but I see it in the cards, so say what you want. The person you're connected with, Two of Coins, they're juggling. So they would be content with juggling. They're, you know, they're not really making a decision. They would juggle both of you. And you're not really giving them that option, so that's why we have the coldness. Yeah. All right, bottom of the deck, Ace of Wands in the reverse. So there is no new beginning in this connection, and there are things that are being hidden, things that are being kept, you know, in the dark here. All right. The energy is there, Virgo. The energy's there. There is a lot of passion in this connection, especially physically, but there's also a lot of love in the connection. I feel like your capacity for love is probably stronger than the person you're connected with because you came out as a freaking Ace of Cups. They came out as a Page. So, you know, that should tell you something as well. But you definitely are seeing them as a player. And they're content to juggle. So, you know, I don't see you being content with that. But your heartstrings are still tied. You're unable to really let this go completely. So let's go ahead and if you'll get a direct question in your mind, I'm going to pull for you from the Angel Answers Oracle. Pulling for Virgo. For Virgo. Okay, just the one. It's It's unusual, but we're going with it. Okay, so your card says improving health. So I don't know if this situation, Virgo, has caused you some health issues or if it's unrelated, but your card is improving health. Okay? All right. So Virgo, I do hope this has been helpful for you. If you haven't already subscribed, please do so. Like and share the video and drop me a comment. I read all of your comments. And so until I see you next week, namaste.